Hey everyone, I am thrilled to introduce you to our new President's Club seven-figure winner. Record time, got to over seven figures in sales, over eight figures in pipeline. Scott Turecek with Juice, one of the top performing digital agencies that came from a group of founders who built their own companies, and now they're helping companies like yours grow. I'm excited for Scott to share his journey from the beginning to where he's at today. Scott, thank you for joining us.
Thank you. I appreciate it. This is a ton of fun. I love the energy.
Yeah. So this is awesome. You guys have an incredible story, Scott. So why don't, for the audience, you give a quick background and introduction to who you are and who you work for and your experience.
Yeah. My name's Scott Turecek. I'm the director of business development over at Juice, thinkjuice.com. It's my job to go out and hunt new logos and work with entrepreneurs really starting up e-commerce brands or applications, launch them into the market or help scale them from something really small to hopefully something really, really big. I've been in sales for about 10 years now, starting off smiling and dialing at a Mercedes-Benz dealership and was able to work my way up and really found my niche when I got into the marketing and advertising world. And I've been loving it ever since, working with either, you know, marketers or entrepreneurs trying to grow businesses, focus on driving as much revenue as possible, help marketers get promotions, and help people, achieve, their dreams, either business-wise or in their personal life.
And you guys do all the innovative digital channels, right? You're like a digital ad and marketing agency, for like even niche networks like Instagram or TikTok. Like, you guys are everywhere, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Facebook, Instagram, Google, they swallow up a lot of client spend, but we focus on any of the digital channels. SEO, we'll get into the influencer part of the world, but we also focus on optimizing, the entire customer journey, not just running advertising. Our real focus as a business is to grow businesses, not to grow ad spend. Being founded by a handful of entrepreneurs that had started and sold and grown businesses themselves, we really just didn't want to be just another agency focused on ad dollars. We want to help people grow businesses and achieve what their dreams are.
That's amazing, man. Well, congrats on the success. And obviously, we're here because you've won, two seven-figure club awards. Talk to me about before, like, it wasn't always like this, right? Where in an eight-figure pipeline, and you guys will probably hit eight figures, I'm hoping, in the next 6 months or less. Talk to me about life before. What was the journey like for you and the team?
Yeah, it was really intimidating. Kind of sitting down and seeing like the amount of green field that I have, right? That's something amazing for a salesperson. They're like, hey, I can go after anything. And then you sit down and you put your hands on the keyboard and you go, oh crap, I can go after anything. Like, what in the world?
Where do I start?
Yeah. So, I mean, we really started off with coming out with an ideal client, profile, who we really wanted to go after, and trying to figure out an efficient way to identify those brands, and more importantly, like, who the contacts at those brands are, so we could overall go out to reach them. So for me, super nervous about wasting time going after the wrong people, whether I'm shooting a little bit too high or a little bit too low. And then in kind of the blocking and tackling of what you have to do to grow a business or a new line of business is, how can I not spend all of my time and things have gotten better over the past 10 years, but I have spent so much time, like, as a salespeople, just sourcing the right brands to go after, trying to find them when they're hitting the right milestones or trying to read their mind on like when I should be reaching out to them, but then also finding and navigating like the org structure of like who actually works there, who is going to be like the champion that I'll talk to, who will be the decision maker, who's going to be influenced by like the product or service that I sell overall. And I had like used a ton of things, before, of like, how can I hack with like $0? Like, how can I figure out somebody's email address based on somebody other's email address? Maybe I should just spam to everybody. Like, I've wasted so much time over my career on just doing like the, you know, 90% of the iceberg that you don't see to get like the 10%, which is the actual outreach and conversations that you've had with people. So going from just a blank Excel sheet to like a Salesforce filled with hundreds of prospects or hundreds of brands, and then thousands of prospects that I can go and reach out to, and then to create some way to rank them and put them in with my ICP thing has been a journey to get from nothing to a full pipeline where it really feels like I'm having the right conversations at the right time.
That's awesome. And where did you net out? Like, you know, because a lot of people viewing may not really have a great formula to go from blue ocean to niche ICP, right? What did you guys decide on and how did you get there?
Yeah, so I found that I needed to work with our account management team to figure out who the best customers were. I can easily see like who spends the most money, but I found that it was super helpful talking to the, you know, the account managers and strategists actually working on a few of the accounts that we had on what did you like about them? Like, what about them excites you to really work on your brand? Because those are the people that are in it, and you can really feel the energy of your team when talking about a client they know can grow and scale and go huge and they like working with, and ones that like don't, it's just kind of like they're paying you, so you're kind of working on it. So I work with them to develop that ideal client profile. We really looked at how many people are on their team, how much they're willing to scale, how much focus that they have on social media, what their like average either cart size or product value is. Are they looking at a subscription model? Using all of that information and then looking at the, I combined that with the type of people in the organization. So for us, we really want to have somebody that has a small marketing team, maybe from 1 to 3 marketers, because that for us means that they're probably not running all of those channels in-house, and that they're going to be a type of help. And then we actually brought it down a little bit more. When we do want to really, really target someone and use like some account-based marketing, is that we profiled out who is the type of person on the other side, what's their mindset, how can we function, how can we figure that out within the first call or two, if this is somebody we truly want to dedicate time to. Because a lot of the times we're working with entrepreneurs that are getting products off the ground, and it's kind of like, okay, we can go all in and spend a ton of time with someone, but we want to engage with the brands and the entrepreneurs that are going, that we can buy into and then scale. And of course, as they scale the business, they can scale the relationship with us. So we've not only targeted like the brand, but also the type of people that really just vibe with us, like as people, as strategists and as marketers.
That's awesome. Wow. Congrats. And then what industries again did you pick there?
Yeah. So for us, digitally native, direct to consumer, brands are probably our bread and butter. CPG and anybody doing different types of lead generation, whether it be for consumer services or maybe an app install.
Okay, awesome. So then you pick your ICP. You're doing all of this hacky stuff that I used to do all the time too. Like I would create like Google Sheet hacks where you just type in a name and then it formulates 90 different email patterns, like all the craziest hacky stuff just to do whatever it took to save time to try to figure out who to contact. And tell us a little bit about how did you go from doing that and wasting all of the hours, and you know, what was the pain that you were experiencing? Then how did you come to Seamless, and then what were the results of post?
Yeah. So, I mean, the pain I was experiencing is really just the time. Sometimes it takes like upper management, you know, a really strong like case study or use case to show them that like, yes, you should spend money on the sales stack to be able to get more production out of it. So I went in and just detailed the amount of time I was going in trying to hack together an email address, and then the number of times that even me, been doing it for years, how many times I'll still be wrong just because those things switch up or people purposely pick you know, email cadences that are a little bit different. So I really went in and just hit a timer and said, hey, this is the time it takes me to source 50 brands, 3 person per brand, 150 people for me to start a cadence or a little cohort that I'll go after. It takes me about 6 hours to do so. Then I downloaded like the free version of Seamless that gave me 100 contacts that I could go into. And I basically said, okay, for my next cohort, I'll just use this. And then I was able to do the same thing, just clicking around on LinkedIn and just hitting the like just show button. And then I was able to do the same thing in 2 hours. So it's like, hi, I can do this in three less hours. Those are 3 hours I can spend doing other things. And what I really saw is like, the email engagement you're going to do, like you'll stay late, like however that happens. But I saw that I was able to focus a lot more time on my proposal building, the actual personalization that I was doing to each person that I'm reaching out to, a little bit more time looking through their Twitter, a little bit more time looking through their overall LinkedIn. And then I was able to work on some other cool stuff, you know, with the marketing team doing some of that one to many outreach just because I had less time doing the sourcing and more time working on other things.
Wow. That's amazing. And how did you hear about us?
From a colleague. I had worked with like some of more of like the legacy larger companies like years ago. So I kind of went back with what I knew. And when I started getting quotes, it was like, you had to buy like an enterprise subscription for like 10 people on your team. And it was, you know, in the five figures, like either per month or per year.
Pricing for this old database.
Yeah, it was this, or products and services that were in there that like I couldn't even utilize or didn't have either the time or like the technical resources. Mm-hmm. So when a colleague of mine mentioned Seamless and that it was just, you could sign up for just one license, you know, $100 or so, whatever it is. It's just like, oh, this isn't some enterprise. This isn't something like I have to put under the sales team budget. This was something that I could be like, hey, boss, can I just expense this? Like, it was like easy peasy, up and going. Like, there was no, there was no fighting. It was just like, this is the cost of like a flight out to a client. Like, this is nothing.
Yeah. You're like, this is stupid. Let's save all this time and effort.
Yeah.
That's absolutely amazing. And then what was it like, you know, from signing up and upgrading to your first seven figures, how much time was that? Because you know, you're over $2 million in sales. Total sales, how much do you think?
So the way that I looked it up when I was preparing for this, so all of the deals that I had closed over the past year had come from sourcing people from Seamless. Awesome. So closed an average of about three deals per month at about 80K of annual worth. And if I were to take that 80K times the 36, that's about 2.8 million total.
Amazing. Congrats.
So for me, it wasn't like this big explosion at the beginning. It was like a nice, the
gradual
way that like cohorts of reaching out to like 100 to 150 at a time. It just really let me to like nice and automate my process and gave me like enough funnel to then just close the opportunities that it would take me to hit it. And it was really cool that our, you know, our line of business was able to get over 100% for each month over the past year.
Wow. And when you say over, got it. So beat quota every month, month over month, essentially.
Yeah, that was the cool thing. I mean, as a salesperson, I've definitely done like the roller coaster of like, you can blow it out one quarter and then maybe it comes down the other, but having this like sustainable process that like, I feel like I just block out a few hours a couple times a week that I can go through has given something like sustainable that like, as a human being, it, you don't have to live that roller coaster as much. I mean, I'll take as many ups as I can, but it's really removed like those lows. Because I'm just having enough conversations.
That's amazing. Well, huge congrats.
Thank you.
So it was probably, you know, if you're doing about 240, 250 a month, probably 4 months until you hit your first million, right?
Yeah.
And then 8 months for the second million or whatever it is. Does that sound about right?
Yeah. It, you know, for me, I don't really think about it. It was crazy when I even saw that number. I'm like, all right, maybe I got like a few hundred thousand dollars of it because I'm just so focused on like, I need to have this many meetings per month and that will get me, if I have the right people, if I have this many meetings per month, I'm going to get to my number. So when I actually, for this purpose, when I actually did it out, I was like, wow, this I think this thing paid for itself.
Dude, that's amazing. We're so happy for you. And then Scott, how has this fundamentally changed your life personally, professionally, mentally, health-wise, anything? Like, would love to just hear how the, you know, it obviously takes Seamless plus hard work plus strategy. Like, there's so much that you have to do with, like, Seamless is just the vehicle that, you know, someone's got to drive the car, do all the work, put the gas in, all of that jazz, right? I call it the Ferrari for salespeople, top salespeople. How has this fundamentally changed your life in different facets of your life?
Yeah, I think for me, what we've seen over, of everything we've seen over the past 6 or 9 months, whatever it is, that type of thing can really make a salesperson whose journey is already up and down, like, can multiply that times 100. For me, always having that sustainable number of meetings and deals in the pipeline really removed a lot of the anxiety when awesome. This was a time that salespeople really had to perform, or else maybe things might go differently than they would be another year. So mm-hmm. for me, being able to remove a lot of, you know, to be honest, a lot of the anxiety you have as a salesperson, knowing that you're going to see performance and your pipeline's going to be there when you look at it down the corner, particularly after you close a deal you've been working on for a while. A lot of the times you might see that funnel shrink. You know, having this process in place that Seamless was a big part of was just calmed everything for me and was able to you know, help me focus, particularly with, you know, and now having a 1 month old and a 2 year old in the house.
Congrats.
It's really nice to have something going that I can, that is predictable and that I can count on. So for me, it's really helped me balance out what's happened over, 2020.
That's amazing. Well, Scott, on behalf of the entire team here at Seamless, we want to say congratulations.
What?
Welcome to the 7-figure President's Club Award.
Yeah.
This award is for you. We built this company to help professionals connect opportunity faster than ever before and positively impact a billion people. And you are a testament to the power of a platform like Seamless and being a top 1% user. I just want to say congratulations. We're thrilled to ship this out to you, man. You should feel really great. You know, you're among the 1% of over 100,000 salespeople and entrepreneurs. So that's absolutely amazing. So first question, where are you going to hang this thing?
Yeah, I'm going to hang it right behind me for all of my Zoom calls. So everybody that I talk to will ask me what in the world, they might think it's a Grammy or something. That
looks yes!
like a big silver thing. So I'll tell them I came out with a hit song and then, you know, we'll just talk to it saying, hey, I live to help out entrepreneurs like you. And this is just a testament to the work I've done.
Yeah. That's amazing, man. Huge congrats. And then, second question, what advice do you have for maybe new salespeople that have just joined Seamless who are watching your interview? And they're like, man, one day I want to be like Scott. I want to accomplish what he did. Or maybe you're a sales veteran. You've been in sales for a very long time and you're dying to win the 7-figure club. And year after year, you just can't do it. What advice do you have for the aspiring and even the vets on, you know, secrets to get to this thing?
Yeah. I mean, the persistent stuff, the outreach, you know, getting better stuff, that's like table stakes for a salesperson. What I found that, like, really helped me as my career grew was the relationship building, the little things, the keeping up with people, to sending emails that have nothing to do with sales just to say hello. The little relationships that I built, even from sales that I made from 8 years ago, that are still people that will check out my email 8 years from then, has helped me tremendously. It helps me start anytime in a new position, or anytime pitching a new product, that I feel like I have this great base that I could reach out to. And that's something that can only happen with years of doing it. So be gracious, reach out to people, stay in touch, not trying to sell them, just build that network of people that will pick up your call because they know they can trust you. And over the course of your time, you'll see that the prospecting and all of that stuff just gets easier. But there's a ton of work you have to do to get that. So don't give up, But keep building those relationships, reach out, congratulate everybody, you know, sincerely on the birthdays and the having kids and, mm-hmm. and when they start new positions, just genuinely reach out and show appreciation to them. And that stuff will come back to you.
That's awesome, man. Well, Scott Turecek over at Juice, thinkjuice.com, huge congratulations. Welcome to the seven-figure club. And then last question, man.
Let's go.
When are we going to see you and when are we jumping back on the line for the eight-figure club award?
Dude, hopefully at the end of this year, I would love to do it, man. I want to be the founding member of the 10-figure club, whatever there is, man. I hope I never stop doing this. I'm pumped up.
That's awesome. Well, last thing, where can the audience connect with you, follow you for more, Scott?
Yeah, they can find me either on LinkedIn, Scott Turecek, the only one in the entire world, so you can't miss me, or you can email me over at scott@thinkjuice.com. Love to connect, network, just talk about anything and everything sales.
Awesome. Congrats again, Scott. On behalf of ours to yours and everyone tuning in, just remember, you're one list away from President's Club and you're one list away from the life you want, the marriage you want, the cars, the houses, the vacations, everything you want in your life is just one list away. Go build that list and go sell to that list and help a lot of people. Thank you for tuning in and huge congrats, Scott.
Thank you.
You earned it.